I'm from Dayton, Ohio, and on behalf of Gina and Tom, I want to thank you all for being here on this glorious day in the middle of God's creation. To be able to be here as Bianco's and Tarnacki's and Douglas's and Icopini's and family and friends in order to witness a miracle. And I'm not talking about the fact that Tom finally found a woman to say yes. The miracle is the creative and life-giving reality of a committed relationship in a marriage. And the best example we can take for that comes from John's Gospel, the most famous wedding in the scriptures, the wedding at Cana. More about that later in terms of wine. But the center of the story is not the wine. The center of the story is the mother who, in the middle of that life-giving experience, goes to Jesus and says, "You have to do something for this moment." And we have a great matriarch mother with us today, Gina's grandmother Marion. We have her mother Nancy. And we can't leave the men out because Grandpa Ernie is home on the farm in Montana. And Brian's Gina's dad, and Tom's dad, Bill Sr., is here. But there's another mother who is present today. And I can see the smile on her face. Diana Bianco Tarnacki, a great and good soul, who is surely smiling. So we remember that mother most of all. But we remember too that at Cana there were family and friends And so Gina has her sisters, Angela and Jacole, as her bridesmaids. And her brother Mitch as a groomsman. And Tom has his brother Bill as his best man. And his sister Leslie as a bridesmaid. And their friends, some reputable, some disreputable, who've gathered here. So as we begin, remember what this is, a true miracle. And remember the mothers who make it so, the fathers who confirm it, the sisters and brothers who share it, and the friends and family who gather to say amen to this miracle. So let's pause for a moment and ask for God's blessing on Gina and Tom. Let us pray. Father in heaven, hear our prayers today for Gina and Tom, who are united in marriage. Give them your blessing, strengthen their love for each other. We ask you this through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading is from the book of Tobit, and Gina's grandmother Marion, a good woman from Montana, is going to do the reading. So I just ask her to come forward.
A reading from the book of Tobit. On their wedding night, Tobiah arose from bed and said to his wife, "Sister, get up. Let us pray and beg our Lord to have mercy on us and to grant us deliverance." Sarah got up and they started to pray and beg that deliverance might be theirs. They began with these words, "Blessed are you, O God our Father. Praised be your name forever and ever. Let the heavens and all your creation praise you forever. You made Adam, and you gave him his wife Eve, to be his help and support. And from these two, the human race descended. You said, 'It is not good for the man to be alone. Let us make him a partner like himself.' Now, Lord, you know that I take this wife of mine not because of lust, but for a noble purpose. Call down your mercy on me and on her, and allow us to live together to a happy old age." They said together, "Amen, amen." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The second reading that Gina and Tom chose is going to be read by Tom's uncle, Skip. So I just ask him to come forward for that reading.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not speak its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It is not rude over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
For the gospel reading, Gina and Tom selected a passage from Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth. But what if salt goes flat? How can you restore its flavor? Then it is good for nothing but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. Men do not light a lamp and then put it under a bushel. They set it on a stand where it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, your light must shine before all, so that they may see the goodness in your acts and give praise to your heavenly Father." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I promised Tom that I would be brief. Those of you who know me realize this is not so easily done. However, some words need to be said. First of all, as some of you know, and it was mentioned last night by me at the rehearsal dinner, they met at a friend's art show in a bar. No surprise Tarnacki would be in a bar. The switch was, he wasn't drinking and Gina was. But she recognized the moment, started a conversation that went on for an hour. And that conversation became part of the ongoing dialogue that has brought them to this day, to these vows, to these rings. And in the process, they discovered their love of wine. And oh, by the way, you will get to sample their handiwork after the wedding. And you yourselves can judge if it's as good as what came at Cana. Their love of travel. And they've traveled many places together. One of the first was a snowboarding experience. Gina was not so happy because she'd been snowboarding a number of times, and Tom outshone her the first crack out of the box. Now, that has to be qualified because they had gone to McDonald's for breakfast before, and unfortunately, the happy meal turned out not to be so happy. So let's just say there were some moments of emergency. They then traveled to the Heskins wedding, and in that travel, the conversation continued, and it showed them that there was a relationship here to be built upon, that was built upon so many things they share in common. And travel, of course, is one of them. And the management has asked me to remind you that when you decide to travel, you should go to www.onedayinacity.com and ask for Gina. She'll be glad to help you in that regard. Now, the key thing about any journey is that it always has stages and elements. And Gina and Tom have known those. But the triumph of their love and the miracle we witnessed today demonstrates their ability to transcend everything that stood in their way to be here this day now. And their readings reflect that. The reading from Tobit is very interesting because here they are, a couple on their wedding night, and they're praying. But the interesting thing is how they pray. They give praise first for creation. Well, that should be self-evident on a glorious day like this. But they also recognize something that I want to remind everyone of here who's in a committed relationship, but especially Tom. The reading uses the word partner to describe Tobiah's wife, Sarah. Well, that's a very unique word in the Hebrew scriptures. And it's used in the Adam and Eve story when Eve comes to Adam. And the word in Hebrew, yes, there's going to be an English lesson, is etzer. The only other time it's used is in reference to angels. So Tom, remember that God has given you an angel to be your partner. And even on the days when you think that halo might be a little bit rusty, remember the gift that Gina is for you. And Corinthians, their second reading. Tom's friend Randy Brunner, when he found out they were choosing, he said, "Why are they taking that reading? Everybody does it. It's so sentimental." And in one way, it is. But that's because people forget about the way the reading ends. Love bears all, forgives all, endures all. So Gina, just as with Tom, bear all, forgive all, endure all. Because he's worth it and you know that. Even as he juggles a job, grad school, and a CFA exam that hangs over his head like a 10-pound weight. And he wishes it to be gone, and soon enough it will be. Then you can take him to Machu Picchu. finally, there's the gospel. And the key words there are salt and light. Salt is what gives life savor. And the greatest gift that I know you as a couple will be able to give people is the savor of your lives together. By your vows, by your rings, by the miracle of every day of your commitment. And you are also light. And light, as the reading says, can't be hidden. Put it on a lampstand so that you can give your light and your warmth and your welcome to all of your family, all of your friends, and all of the days that are to come. There is, in fact, the simple joy of partnership. The recognition that in partnership all can be endured, and the gift that you give to everybody as a couple, as their salt, as their light, from this day until forever. Amen. And Tom, you've come together today so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church and this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. Christ has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of this company and God's creation, I ask you to state your intentions. Gina and Tom, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and the church? Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I ask you to declare your consent before God and this company. I, Tom, take you, Gina, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. I, Gina, take you, Tom, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. You have declared your consent before God. May the Lord's goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with God's blessings. When God is joined, men must not divide. Amen. Kiss your wife. Gina, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Tom, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. As we get ready to conclude, just take a moment and reflect on all the ways that Gina and Tom are part of our lives, and pray quietly that that love that they've demonstrated today with their vows and their rings and their commitment to one another is something we can all share with them in all the days to come. Let me offer a final blessing. Tom and Gina, we ask God for his continued blessing on you. We ask our Father, the creator of the universe, maker of woman and man, source of blessing for married life, to be there with you as we pray for you, Gina, and for you, Tom. We're united today in this sacrament of marriage. May your fullest blessing come upon both of them, Lord, so that they can rejoice together in your gift of married love. Lord, may they both praise you when they are happy and turn to you in their sorrows. May they be glad that you help them in their work and know that you are with them in their need. May they pray to you in the community of the church and be your witnesses in the world. May they reach old age in the company of their family and friends and come at last to the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. It gives me the greatest joy possible to introduce to you Gina and Tom Tarnacki.
And I know is really greener. Warm, wet and wild. There must be something in the water. Sipping gin and juice, laying underneath the palm trees.
Okay.
And then the birds break their necks, trying to creep a little sneak peek.
What? What?
Share the night, it goes on.